Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, assalamu alaikum. This is your mathematics class for grade 4 from Pakistan International School 5. And today we are going to start page number 97. Open book page 97. There is the topic decimals, tens and hundreds. Okay, first of all we have to know that what is tens. When we divide a square into 10 equal parts, then we say each part 1/10. For example, this is a square. We divide into 10 equal parts. Okay? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. This is a square. We divide into 10 equal parts. Each part we say 1/10. Or we can say like this one. 1 over 10. 1/10. Or you can say that this one 0.1. 1/10 or 0.1. We divide this square into 10 equal parts. Each part is called 1/10. So this is about 4/10. And if we divide each part by 100, then we say 1/100. Like this one, 1/100. Then we say 1, 2, and 2, 0. We say 0.01. Okay, let's do it. We have divided this square into 100 parts. This is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, this is 100. Now we have to divide this square into 100 equal parts, and each part is called 1/100. 1/100. Okay, dear students. On page number 97, you have question number 2. Color square to match the decimal number. Okay, you have question number 2. Part A, the square is given like this one. On the book, you have just color. In part A, the question is 0.02. 0.02. Mean we have to color two boxes. Anywhere you can color two boxes. Anywhere. From here, from here, from here, from here. Anywhere you can color, because there are two boxes. This is 1 and this is 2. So you have to color these boxes from anywhere on the graph paper or the book. This is answer 0.02. So next one is also B, 0.18, C 0.51, D 0.75. You have to color on the book like this one. Okay. Question 3 is also same. You have to take a graph paper like this one and color these on graph paper. And then you have question number 4. Write these as decimal numbers. Okay, dear students. This is question number 4, part A. 46/100. So we have to write as decimal. It's a very easy way to write the decimal. First of all, you write this one same as it is, like this one, 4, 6. The easy way, you have to count how many zero, 1, 2. You count 1, 2, and then in place of 1, you have to put the point. Okay, dear students, you have to write 46, and then we have to put the point. How many zero are there? 1, 2. We count 1, 2, and then put the point and 0. This is your answer. Okay, there is another part B, like this one, 7 over 100. So we have to write first of all 7, and then we count how many zero, 1, 2. But there is one number, 1, there is no another number, so we put by ourselves 0, and then put point. And then we say 0.07. This is the answer. Because there is one number 7, there are two zero, 1, 2, 1, 2, and then put point here. And same in C, 16 over 100. We have first of all write this one, 16, and then we count 1, 2, 1, 2, and then put point, and this is 0.16, and this is the answer. Okay, dear students, next question number 5. Question 5 is, write these as fraction. Now decimal is given, now we have to write in fraction. Like this question 5 part 1, 0.15. 0.15 we have to change into fraction. So first of all, we write this 1, 5, 1, 5, and then we line. This is point, we put 1, and after point 1, 2, 2 digits we put 2, 0. This is the answer. Okay? And if you can divide by a table, like table of 5, we can divide. 5 threes are 15, and 100 divided by 5 will be 20. This is your answer. Okay? In B, you have 0.56. This is decimal. We have to change into fraction. 5, 6 means it is 56, and then we have, this is the point, in place of point we put 1, and this 1, 2, 2, 0, and then we can divide it by this, by the table of 2, and you simplify your answer. So 56 divided by 2 will be 28, and 100 divided by 2 will be 50. Again you can see that we can divide by 2, so we have to divide again by 2. 28 divided by 2 will be 14, and 50 divided by 2 will be 25, and further we cannot divide, so this is the answer. Okay? And then you have C. In C, you have 0.10. First of all, we change into fraction. We write this one, and then line. In place of point, we put try 1, and 1, 2, 2 digits, we put 2, 0. And then we divide by this 10. So 10 divided by 10 will be 1, and 100 divided by 10 will be 10, and this is the answer. Okay, same in D, you can see that 0.03. So first of all, we write this in fraction. You write 0 over, in place of point we write 1, and then 1, 2, 2, 0. And we cannot divide. by 100 and 0, if we ignore 0, then you write like this one. 0, 3 are 3 same. And then you have E 0.01. This is the question. We have to write in fraction form. After point we write this 0.1 and then we write 100 because 2 0. So we ignore this 0, 1 over 100. This is your answer. Next, F. F is 0.33. First of all, we write this into fraction 33 and then 0.1. Two digits we put 20. And we cannot further divide by this is 33 and this is 100. And this is your answer. Okay, dear students, I hope you understand. Dear students, this is counting in decimal 0.01, 0.01, 0.02. I know you know these 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07. So you knew this counting. After this 0.010, then you have 0.11, 0.12, 0.17, 0.18, and 0.19, 0.20. This means when you have 0.20 is equal to 0.2. These are same. When you have 0.20, 0.20 or 0.2, this is same. This is not 0.02. This is 0.2 means 0.20. So you have to keep in mind that 0.2 means 0.20. Here also 0.10 means 0.1. Look here. This is not 0.1, this is 0.01. 0.02, 0.03, you have to keep in mind. 0.10 or 0.1 is same. 0.20 or 0.2 is same. Same here. 0.50 or 0.5 same. 0.60 is equal to 0.6. 0.70 is equal to 0. These are same. Okay, that says 0.01. This is 0.01, 0.02. Okay, you have to keep in mind. This is question number 6. Think carefully, then fill in the greater or smaller or equal. Okay. I write these questions here and then I will tell you answer. This is question number 6. You have to fill with this greater or smaller or equal. So as I told you that you have to keep in mind this is 0.05, this is, and this is 0.50. So you know that which one is greater? 50. This is greater. And here you can see 0.19, 0.91. So this is 19, this is 91. You write simple, this is greater. Here, 50 over 100. So you know this answer. You will change into decimal. 50 over 100. So first of all, you write this one. 50 and then how many 0, 1, 2, 1, 2 after this, you put point and say this is, and 0.50, 0.5 same, as I told you this one 0.50, 0.5 same, so mean these are equal, 50 over 100, 0.5 are equal. Okay dear students, these are equal because this is equal to 0.5. These are same, 50 over 100 equals 0.50 and 0.5 same. Indeed, you have 0.08 and 1. This is 0.1 mean, 0.1 mean 0.10. This is 0.10. This is 0.08. This is 0.10. So which one is greater? This is greater. Okay. Same here, 0.6 means 0.60. This also 0.60 mean these are equal. Okay. And here is 0.75. So you have to change into fraction. 0.75. We have to change 75 as it is. And then after 0.1220, 75 or 100 mean these are equal. So we have got equal sign. Okay, next question 7 is also very easy. See here, for example, this is 72 over 100. We can write this 72, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, and this is 0.72. This is called tenths. Okay, dear students, keep in mind, after the point, this number is called tenths. After tenths, you have this one. This is called hundredths. Okay. This one is hundredths. After point, this is called tenths. After tenth, this is hundredths. So you have to keep in mind, there is question number 7. Question number 7 is very easy if you understand. This is part A. Here is a 3 tenths and 5 hundredths. Mean 3 tenths, 5, this is tenths, this is hundredths. So put point and this is answer. This is tenths, this is hundredths. You have to put 0.35. In part B, we have 0 tenths and 9 hundredths. So this is tenths and this is hundredths. And put point and zero. Okay? And see, 8 tenths, 0 hundredths. This is 0.1. This is 8 tenths and 0 hundred. You can write down this one. Okay? And then, in D, 1 tenths, 4 hundredths. This is 1 tenths and 4 hundredths, and this is also. Okay, dear students. Now it's time for your homework. Page number 97, question number 2, I did part A. You will do part B, C, and D at your book. Question number, this is homework. Page number 97, question 2, you have to do these on your book, part B, C and D. You have to do these at your book page, but question number 3, you have to buy a graph paper like this. You can see on the book, question number 2, graph paper, this is also called squared paper. In this question number 3, you have to color A, B, C, D, E, F parts. in graph paper. So all parts you have to color in graph paper. Okay, dear students, this is your homework. I hope you understand, and if you have problem, you can ask me.